said, boy, you might not understand, but a long, long time ago, grandma's daddy didn't like me none, but I loved your grandma so. We had this crazy plan to meet and run away together, get married in the first town we came to and live forever. But nailed to the tree where we were supposed to meet instead.
And folks,
I found this letter, and this is what it said. If you get there before I do, don't give up on me. I'll meet you when my chores are true. I don't know how I'll be, but I'm not gonna let you down. Darling, wait and see. Between now and then, until I see you again, I'll be loving you. Love me. I've read those words just hours before my grandma passed away.
Alright, this is for Carpy, Chris, Gilligan, and Caroline.
If you get there before I do, don't give up on me. I'll meet you in my chores are true. I don't know how long I'll be, but I'm not gonna let you down. Darling, wait and
song is for Carpy's Chris's son and Gilligan's son, who are in hospital, and may they get well soon. So good evening, folks, and welcome back to another episode of Paranormal Tech. We are live here in County Louth. And we're at a location, an unbelievable location where we're located tonight. We're going to get to the story in 2 minutes, but let's go back to that song I played. That song is dedicated for Carpy Chris' son, who's recovering in hospital, and Gilligan's son as well, who's in hospital. That song is dedicated for the two sons that are in hospital. Carpy Chris, I hope he's making a speedy recovery. His son is in hospital, and Gilligan. So we hope that all make a speedy recovery. So that song is dedicated for them too, and let's hope that they'll get a bit of luck and their life will turn around. So good evening, folks, and welcome to another episode of Paranormal Tech. My name is Philip. If you watch it for the first time, Caroline's at home on the live chat. You'll see her there in a couple of minutes coming up as Paranormal Tech. That is Caroline, and she's at home with all the kids this evening, and I just left home tonight. I am at a wonderful, wonderful location. This place where I am tonight is absolutely, absolutely fantastic indeed. St. Mochta's Monastery, we're located in County Louth. Now, in the thumbnail in tonight's episode, let's turn around the camera for a second. So let's get back here. So in the thumbnail in tonight's episode, let's turn up the camera, you would have seen bones. You would have seen bones here on the logo on the thumbnail. And I just found out why these bones are be able to be seen. So I'm going to get to that story in a few minutes. So this is a monastery called St. Mochta's Monastery, going back many, many years ago. So there's people in at the moment, and they're... Come on, you come up here. Come on. So we have a little doggy here. So we're, the story goes back in the famine days in Ireland. This is a true story, not messing. So I actually can maybe leave the stuff here and come back to it in a few minutes, because I'm going to give you a guided tour of the place first. So what I'm going to say to you guys is, back in its heyday, back in St. Mochta's Church, back in the famine days in Ireland, and the people of Ireland, this is a true story because I just have to get here, the people of Ireland used to come in from the surrounding areas up here when the kids were absolutely sick and they were dying, and they had no money to keep the kids afloat and keep them nurtured. And when the kids got sick, they used to bring them in here to this monastery, in here to the right hand side, where are you going to see it tonight? And what happened is that the monks and the priesthood who are located here in this monastery here, right here beside me on the right hand side, they used to bring their kids up here to the gates, right up here. And when they had no solution to the problem for starvation, just want to check, make sure I have the keys there. Yeah, when the kids were starvations, and when the kids were dying with starvation, and the kids had diseases, whatever they had back in them times, they used to bring the kids up here to the monastery and walk them into the church and ask the priest, could they look after them and mind them? And what happened then is what the priest would look after them for a certain amount of time when they died or whatever, and when they had no cure for them, and they used to put them into them tombs. There's different names for the tombs, I was told them, but I forgot about them. And there's a tomb on the left, and there's a tomb on the right. So when you've seen the photograph, when I put the photograph up, and you've seen the pictures of the bones and the skulls, they're actually all from the people over the famine years, when the people used to bring them in here to the monastery in here, and the monks. And when the kids did die, the priests put them into these little tombs where you can see open today, and they're the skulls of all the kids and children that the monks and the priests put into the tombs, one to the left and one to the right. There's another outdoor building here called St. Mochta's House. It's out here in the middle of the field. It's actually a two-story house, and it's believed as well that the people of the parish used to bury their babies as well in around St. Mochta's House here. There's no signs of any graves, but there's people cleaning the graves here at the moment in here, cutting the grass, and it says there's hundreds of kids buried around the area of St. Mochta's House. We will show you that in a minute. There's a story of another woman here as well. She served in World War One. She's actually a nun, and she's buried in here. And there's some big names buried here in this monastery. If we can get the people that are cleaning up, the people, there's a few old folks in here, and if they can give us the permission for 5 or 10 minutes and try and get some of the history in it. We actually have another man here as well. He is another YouTuber, and he's actually on the same location as well. And he does go around Ireland as well, done research. And he's actually going to do his little blog. I don't know if he's going to do a vlog tonight. We're just going to ask. Are you going live on YouTube tonight, Redden?
No, I'll be writing a blog.
You're writing a blog. Do you mind stepping into it? No? Do you mind stepping into it? Hello?
Hello. Hi.
So, you might tell the folks who you are.
My name's Seamus Hanratty, and I write a blog. It's called secretireland.ie is the website. And I visit historical websites and locations kind of like this. I was in Castle Roach. I wrote a blog on Castle Roach last month. And got published on a website called Irish Central.
Yes.
And it's the biggest Irish-American website in America. And you get about 1 million visitors a month. So I published a blog on that last month. So
you should look at our video we did in Castle Roach, because we got some amazing results in it.
Right.
You have to watch it.
It's a beautiful place.
It's a beautiful place. It's actually better just before dark. Yeah. And it comes to life that time. You have to see it really come to life.
Yeah.
Come here, the folks are watching on. There's only 14 watching now at the moment, because I'm started a bit early. What history do you know about St. Mochta's? What do you know about it?
To be honest with you, I actually don't know that much. That's why I'm visiting it, try and find out the history.
Right, there's three ladies here cleaning the graveyard, how to speak.
Yeah.
And they're saying that the monks, in the time that Ireland had the famine, when the kids used to be dying and there was starvation, they used to march the kids up here to this gate here when they were dying.
Yeah.
And they were starving. priest used to look after the kids. And when the kids died, they put them in the tombs here on the left and right, and they buried them all around here at St. Mactus Church. And a lot of the kids haven't even got a grave over them. They're just buried and forgotten about.
Right. Yeah. That's amazing.
And that's what people did in the Irish family years when the kids starved. They thought the priesthood was the way to answer it.
Yeah.
But she was saying here that they found hundreds of babies and buried here, and not even a grave over them at all, just
Whoa.
Buried. And that's what. So what happened is, what she's saying is, where the monks used to take the kids in from the Irish people back in the famine time, and when they died, they just put them in the tombs. They didn't just left them in there.
Yeah.
So there's one. She did tell you a story about a nun back in World War II. Is that, you don't remember the name, no?
No, she said there was a tombstone of some nun that was involved in World War II. Then she did mention was when they were looking over this place about 3 years ago, they discovered a tomb, and the tomb had three bodies in it, but the hands were gone from the three bodies.
Yeah, that's right.
So these people were decapitated. So whatever happened there.
And she says they were priests, didn't she?
No, well, she reckoned they were monks.
Yeah.
That's what they suspect, but don't know fully.
Yeah, but what they used to do years ago, if the priesthood, if they stole or they committed a crime, and it must have been an awful crime if they were monks, and they, and they cut their arms off.
Yeah.
So there must be some reason by that. Unless they did something to these kids here in this graveyard, we don't know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that is another possibility. So
it's crazy.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give these guys a guided tour, and then I'm going to start my investigation and see how we get on. So thanks
Enjoy
very much.
So
no bother. So that is some rough of the history, which I hope you're taking it in. So Anne Reid, I hope you're taking all this in. So Laura, so what's your impression? Are you taking all this in? So this is a monastery located in County Louth, and a monastery that the poor people of Ireland came here with their kids from starvation, and the kids that were absolutely in starvation, and they were dying, and the people of Ireland brought their kids and children in here to the monastery for the priest to look after. And when the kids died, the priest put them in little tombs in this monastery here. And there's a little place here called St. Mactus House, and they bury the kids all around the area with no headstones. So I'm hoping, looking forward. Let's turn around the camera and let's get up and running, because Caroline's at home, and Caroline is going to be looking for me to come home in about an hour's time, and I need to try and give you a guided tour of the place as well, and come back here and get my ghost equipment stuff and see if we do a spirit box. So let's give you a guided tour of the place first. Let's bring you through it. The sun is going down, so another beautiful place here. And so what we're going to do, we're going to take you to St. Mactus place first, and there's some lovely armchairs here. Not alone though. So Caroline's chatting you all the way there. And I'm ignoring chat. Let Caroline start with chat. I'm going to bring you through as much history as I can. This place has really, really got me interested, especially with all the kids that are buried in this location. That is the gates. So if you can picture, that was the gates off the monastery. The people are in cutting the grass, and we won't let them cut the grass, and when they're finished, we'll come back to it. That is the gates of the monastery, where the people of Ireland brought their sick kids and children here to the gates of the monastery for the priesthood to take care of the kids, and hopefully come back and the kids would be cured. But unfortunately, the kids died, and they put them in tombs, and they put them in unmarked graves as well. So let's take you down here to some sides of the monastery. We take you down to St. Mactus Chapel, St. Mactus House actually. So we're just going to take you down here first. So we'll take you on a wee tour down here, and we'll bring you through bit by bit. So these are the high walls of the monastery here. It's a beautiful day in Ireland. It was actually 28 degrees today in Ireland. Not much sun, but 28 degrees. So in these grounds here, as you can see, these are grounds here, there's hundreds of kids buried here in this land here, unmarked graves from the priesthood. So take that into consideration as well. So we have to do a spirit box session, walk around here. She said there's hundreds of kids in this location, outside the monastery, buried here in this ground as well, unmarked graves. Into consideration as well before we go over to St. Mactus House. The reason we're called St. Mactus, because St. Mactus, that is where the saint St. Mactus stayed and prayed. It is a one bedroom a little house upstairs, but they blocked it off to stop people going in for ruin it. But that is St. Mactus House, and they buried all the children all around this place here, and that is the monastery itself. So we'll get into the monastery in a couple of few minutes. So Anne Reid's asked me a question there, I guess the chat is gone. This was a monastery of priests and monks, And I think bad things happened here. And Ireland haven't got a great history here of priesthood, or the monastery, or the Christian Brotherhood, or monks. But if you can picture here, here's the monastery here, that's the monastery here in the background. Now, there is some big saints buried in here. We're going to have to ask the people inside, do they mind coming to the camera for a few minutes? This is going to take more than one investigation to check this place out. She says they found a tomb in here. And in the tomb, it goes down two stories, and there's two monks inside the tomb with their arms cut off, she says, and the tomb is there today, she says, and the two monks, and how did she know there were monks? And she says the big crosses are still on beside where the bones are, and she said, no, you know yourself, add one and one together, these priests weren't good back in the heyday, but they're saying there's loads of bodies of different kids buried here around St. Mochta's house here. Unmarked graves, because there's so many kids. You can picture now, come back hundreds of years ago in Ireland, when Ireland had really, really, really bad times with the famine and all that, even way, way before that as well. And the people of Ireland used to always consider the priesthood and the monasteries for safe keep, and they brought their kids here to St. Mochta's monastery to hope that the kids would get cured. And unfortunately, thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands of kids have died. And you can see that's why there's so many skulls and bones in some of these tombs where the priests and the monks just fired them in. But the woman says that there's hundreds of young wee babies buried in around here, this ground. So when we do our spirit box session, let's hope we have enough time to do everything tonight. Carney says she'd love to come here. So this is St. Mochta's house. And there's actually a grave built by St. Patrick himself as well in this graveyard. We'll show you in a few minutes. So that is St. Mochta's house. You can see it there. Look, it's Medish Stone. There's Medish Stone there. And we'll get into it in a minute. It says here, according to the legend of this church, this church was built in a night to give shelter to the founders of St. Mochta's, who died in the year 534. The church was built until the 12th century. It was a very good example of Irish type of people of roof construction. You can see the roof. You can see the roof there. It's made of stone. And it's which prevents it from falling inwards. A stairway leads up to the upper floor between the vault and roof. So there is one bedroom up there. There's no way we can get inside, but we can walk around it and show it to you. So we're just going to walk around and show it to you. And then we'll try and get into the graveyard as well and give you a guided tour of the graveyard. We'll definitely set up the rampart as well outside the tomb where all the bones and the skull. So we'll definitely show you that as well. So we're just going to try and get it through as much as we can. I was going to go to Termefecken tonight, but this location popped up and it could not be missed. No way can it be missed. So we're going to try and do as quick as we can as well, because Caroline is on her own. That is the church, but it is locked up. So I don't know if I can get inside it here, guys, for you. Let's try and get it in. That's what it looks like inside. And over there to the left-hand side there, there's a stairway that goes up to one bedroom. And you can see it's all made of stone as well. And this is where St. Mochta's little church used to be as well. Well, there's no way we're going to get inside there because it's all locked. And you can see how it's all made of stone, pepper stone all around. You can see it there yourself. So that's that. We're not going to get in. It is locked. So let's try and bring the camera out again. Microphone. Sorry, guys. St. Mochta's. Yeah. So let's bring you around, let's show you what it looks like, and then we'll go over to the monastery. But you know what? What's really, really... Let's turn around the camera here. Let's turn around the camera. But what really, really get me, because I'm from Ireland, is what's really, really get me here is St. Mochta's. I might be pronouncing it wrong. St. Mochta. The man said in there, St. Mochta. St. Mochta's church is... That's what the Irish people would have done them days, in the years when the people were starving, the potato blight and all that shite, and when things were so bad back in Ireland, back in them days. That's what M-O-T-C-H-I is. Mochta's. Mochta's. What the Irish is, Mochta's. That's not what the people would have done that. The people would have turned their faces and their souls and hearts to the priesthoods and the monks. Because they had no money, and people had, to this day, people didn't have money, they didn't have, and people used to turn to the priesthood for help. And you could picture, with that, the lady told me the story there, and I really got into her story when she told me the story about the Irish people years and years and years, going back in the year 500s, when the people brought the kids to this monastery, to the monks and the priests, where the kids were starvation and where they were dying with the hunger. And when the kids died, the priests and the monks made tombs and put them into it and buried the kids around St. Moctus house here behind me. And for the lady who was speaking there a few minutes ago, it says that there's many of a child buried here around this house and they're unmarked graves. They would not turn to priests now. Not a hope and chance would they turn to priests, I don't know. So let's get on to it and let's turn around. So let's show you this little place here. So and you can see it up there, little house, and there's actually one little bedroom, but there's a little doorway down there to the right hand side. That little corridor goes up and just in one little floor, but it's all blocked up now because Ireland's youth today, if they got inside in it, if they go in and destroy it, like they always do, destroy it from the youth today. So that's St. That's St. Moctus' house. I'm going to call it, like, I'll get the right name for it in a minute. I know Caroline's spelling it out there, but it's St. Moctus. I'm calling it. But in this area around here where this little house, St. Moctus house, is that there's hundreds of kids buried around here. Well, we'll find out later on when we put on the spirit box session. We walk around, see do we get any kids coming through. We will do that. So let's make our way into the monastery. See can we get anybody to come forward and tell us any wee story about the monastery. Let's see can we get them before they disappear. You'll see that in a few minutes. So let's get into it. Now I know one grave where the bodies are, where you can see the skulls and the legs and the arms, and the Wi-Fi will cut as soon as you go down the steps, but it'll come back as soon as you come back. But we'll try and give as much evidence as we can. We'll give a walk into the monastery now and see what we pick up. If we can get some of the people to come forward and tell us some of the story. Some people don't like to come forward, they just like to leave it alone, so that if they want to be left alone, we left them alone. If they're willing to come forward, fair enough, let them come forward. We're just going to walk around here. Look at the big high walls around the monastery here, absolutely huge place back in the time. And I like to give a guided tour of the place first, and when we walk to the guided tour, then let's walk in with the equipment. Let's put the ramp pod beside the tomb. Let's put on the spirit box. Let's call out on the monks. Let's call out on the children that have passed away. Let's see, can we pick up Eden? There is supposed to be a lady that served in World War I, and she was a nun. She's buried here, and there's some big saint buried here as well. So we'll try everything. We'll give you a guided tour first. So we're going to go in the monastery now. So what's trying to get me here, if you can picture the people walking the kids into this monastery, it's absolutely unbelievable. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and walk around as much as we can and try and give you a guided tour of the place. So we'll walk around and we'll try and pick it in. So we walk through, the people of the community are in here, they are cutting the grass and they're doing a fantastic job. One man says that the grass was about 4 or 5 foot high at one stage. This little chapel here, there's a name for each one of the chapels here on the right side. This one here on the right hand side was built by St. Patrick here on the right hand side. And in this grave in here right inside, there are bones of young children and men and women here on the right hand side, and it's believed that St. Patrick himself came and built one of these tombs here. This is the one they said St. Patrick built on the right hand side, and this is where the priests and the monks would have put the kids who have passed away, or women and children who have passed away. They were handed into the monastery in here. This is one tomb here. We will show you in a few minutes, and if anybody wants to come forward to tell us any history, they can. We're going to let them cut the grass. Maybe they might come and give us a small information if you can before you leave. So what we're going to do, this is the monastery itself. Yeah, as you can see, there's hundreds and hundreds of tombs. You can see them there. And I would say nearly 90% of them are all young people down there. You can see them there, all unmarked graves. Loads and loads and loads of them. That is the monastery itself. We will get into it in a second, but I'm just going to bring you over here to this one here. This was here. This is one of the tombs here built by St. Patrick himself. And how I got the word St. Patrick is because one of the ladies here, they were cutting the grass here, saying this was one of the tombs that St. Patrick built. So what I'm trying to say to you is, I will turn on the light, I will switch on the light, but these of Ireland, when they brought their kids and young children here to the priests and the monastery of the monks to hope that they'll give them some would feed and food and hope that they would look after the kids, and 90% of all these kids died, and this is where the priests and the monks put the kids when they died. So I don't know if you're going to see it, and we can't, the door's locked, so we're just going to try and get it as much as we can, if we can get it in for you guys. Let me see, can we get it in at all? There's actually, it's very hard for you to see, but I can see there's a tomb in there, and we have at least, there must be about, there's loads. You can see the hands, and you can see the skulls, you can see the legs, and you can see the whole lot in here, guys, on the right hand side. But it's very hard for me to get it. I need to bring down the next big light for you to see it, and there you go. So I'm going to try and zoom in. You can actually see a hand on the right hand side up there. Let's see, and we're just going to bring it there. Can you see it there, guys? And you can see all the veins there. That is one side there. So we're bringing it in here to the left-hand side. Don't know if we can get as good as that side. So we'll try and bring it in. Very hard for me to get in there, guys. There's actually another one there, but it's very, very hard for me to get it on that one. And it's very, very hard for me to pick that one up there, but you'll have to try. I think the closest one that I can get, I would suppose, here. We'll try and zoom it out again. There we go, try and zoom it out. We'll just try and turn up this light here. And we'll try and bring it in that way. There you go. There. So that is one tomb that is in there. And Caroline asked me a question. Caroline asked me a question. What's the story with all the bodies in the tomb? So we found out what the story was. The story is, now you all know, is that the people of Ireland brought the kids and children here to the monastery for the priests and the monks to feed their kids and bring them back to health. But when they died, they fired them into this tomb, and there's another one. So we'll come back to it in a minute. Let's keep walking. So let's go in. So let's bring you around. This monastery, it's a huge, huge place, but the people have they have a massive job on them. Look at the height of the grass, and they're bringing it right down to the tombs. And you know what? To do this, for the people of the community to come in here and to clean this place up, it's a miracle itself, because it takes some work to cut this grass. Absolutely amazing for the people to come in here and to cut this grass. I know myself, it's a hard, hard job, but the community of this area to come in and cut this grass to make it for us and for everybody else to come in and see. Not forgetting about St. Mochta's Monastery, and it's a wonderful, wonderful place, and it's a wonderful feeling. So let's bring you through it bit by bit. So if anybody picks up anything as we walk around, please let me know, because I'm going to walk around as much as I can, and let me know what you're picking up as well. We're going to walk around as much as we can. We're going to walk around each corner of the graveyard. Then we're going to walk into the monastery, and we'll try and show you the other one, where the other graves, where all the other kids were thrown into. And then we'll start our investigation then. So we're going to bring it right around. A fair play to the people that are coming here cutting this grass, because there's many of the people that were buried here and forgotten about. As you can see here, all these tombs in here. You can see all these tombs. These are all people that... the monks have buried here over the years, and the children and a lot of people from the village as well over their time have been buried here as well. You can see the cross on these. These were probably monks that actually worked and lived here. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring you through as much as we can first. Then we'll go into the monastery, and then we'll show you the other one. Just going to try and bring walk. If anybody in chat, if anybody our followers sees it or picks up, and make sure you let me know, and I will go back to that place where you're telling me. I'm going to try and get as much as we can as well. So take it all in, guys. Take it all in. Every bit of it, take it all in. So what I do is I want to take it all in and try and show you as much as we can. So we're going to try and bring you through, and we're trying to pick it up. Look at all these graves here, all these ones with the small headstones. These are all unmarked graves here, especially here where we are coming up here to the heart of these would have been, to me, these are graves of kids and children that were, the monks would have put down these little headstones, because I came across these in a few other investigations. These are marks of young graves of children, definitely 100%, the ones with the small stones that are up here. So we're going to go through here. The people that are cutting the grass legged it because they think I'm mad. So let's bring you through it. Okay, but you can just... Let's try and bring it as much as we can. Spirit box session. This is the other tomb here on the right-hand side. This is the other tomb here on the right hand side where we're going, is where the priests, monks, there's two monks buried in here. This tomb here, the two monks buried in here. This is the tomb that they found here. Let me show you now. Down here. You can see the headstone there, right? Let's get this right. So there's the headstone, rest in peace. Let's get into it. The cross, see the HS and the cross and the RP written on top of it. Can you see that there? And that is the tomb. Now, let's turn this around. So, this tomb here, where we're looking at down here, this tomb here is where the locals came in here and they're tidying it up, and they came across this tomb. This tomb was all covered up in stone, and the story goes that when the people found this tomb, I think I have the right tomb, unless there's another one inside, but the lady in question says that there's two monks buried in here, stretched out, with their hands cut off them, up under their elbows. And there's two priests buried in here. Now, Caroline and myself were here today, and we tried to get in there to have a look. And you can see that is the logo of the photo of this thumbnail of them bodies that you see in there. There's about four or five bodies in there, and there's two monks in there with their arms cut off. Why would the people cut back? Think about this one. Back in its heyday, back in the year 500s, why would monks cut off other monks' hands and put them in there to die? That's a strange one. A very, very strange one. Why would monks cut off other monks' hands and put them in there? He is over the tomb. Well, that is the tomb. I feel very choked up now. But what I'm going to do is, I don't know if I have the right tomb now, but that's the story the woman told me. But that is the tomb there. I'm going to walk down as far as I can, but I know the Wi-Fi will go as soon as I get to the gate. And if it goes, I'll come back, okay? TV monks, yeah, they're saying. So let's try and get it, but that is the tomb itself. So let's try and get down to it. Now, I don't know if the Wi-Fi is going to stay, but that is the tomb. So there it is. Just going to show you where I'm standing. Right up here. and I'm going to make my way down to this tomb now. And I'm not guaranteeing I'm going to get to it. I'm not going to guarantee that I'm going to get into it. I guarantee the Wi-Fi is going to jump and I'm going to have to leg it out. So let's go down here. Let's hope that Wi-Fi would stay so you can see the bodies. Now, I know you can see a bone there already, guys. And if I can get a bit closer, I'm hoping that you guys could see the skull that I could see looking at me from here. There's definitely one big skull there. There's actually more than one skull there if I can get into it. I'm going to have to bring the other big light down so you can see it. I'm going to try and move out. If the Wi-Fi goes, guys, I will come back again. But there's me. I can see in my camera, I can see three or four different skulls and I can see a hand. But definitely, I'll try and get a bit closer for you guys so you can see it. I'll try and get a bit closer. Wi-Fi goes, guys, I'll jump out again and I'll bring down the bigger light so you can see it. It's staying anyway, guys. There you go. Can you see that, guys? There's three skulls there, if not four. There's one massive one down there. And if I can get that one, it'll be amazing. I'll try and get a bit closer. Can you see that skull there, guys? I can see. There's hundreds of bodies there, guys. They're not just one body, guys. Quickly, there must be 20 or 30 bodies on there, guys. Absolutely human. So we're just going to turn this back here. We did very well now to get far as the gate itself. Can you all tell me in chat, could you see the bodies? Could you see the skulls? Could you see it all? I could see it. Can you tell me in chat, could you see it? In chat, please let me know, because it's be very good if we can get it. Yes, there's no bones in the walls here we deliver it true, we deliver it right as we can. So what we're going to do, guys, we're going to show you another one or two tombs here. There's another one up here on the left. We'll get them on the way out. There's two ladies up here in question. Do you want to have a chat? No, we want to leave your equipment down with you. No bother. Any of you want to say a small story for us? Are you sure? No. They brought her equipment down. That's fine. You can leave it there at the gate. And I locked the gate on the way out in. That's fine. Lovely. Fair play to you. No bother. Thanks very much. Thank you. Thank you. So they brought my equipment. I left it out under the car. So fair play to them. They brought it down far as the gate. They didn't want to come on. They didn't want to speak. They didn't want to come on television. Anne-Marie's ghost box by the tomb. Philip, I saw a child stood there. Definitely. Is that the tomb you're about down there, Anne? That tomb? Yeah. Caroline, and there's 24 people watching right now. Did you see all the bodies in that tomb? Did you see all the bodies in that tomb? Absolutely amazing. So let's turn around the camera. Let's try and get the guided tour. I'm mad to get the RAM pod up and running. And I want to take you to this one here. James O'Carroll is written over this tomb here. James O'Carroll, in the years of our Lord, 1800. Let's go to this one. So James O'Carroll, in the year of our Lord, 1800, for him and his... What the hell was that? I thought I heard something there. This lab was rewarded in 1943 by the great-grandson, James Marriton Glenmore Carroll, House of Drogheda. So there's a big, huge tomb here with a big door in it. You can see it here. You can open this big tomb here, and believe it or not, we can go in it. We can go in this tomb, and there's a tomb in here, and there's actually people buried in this tomb as well. This tomb had a roof in it at its time, and the people are buried here in this, underneath these slabs of concrete, believe it or not. So that would have been the tomb to go into it. There was a roof here in its heyday over it, and the people are buried here under this. So let's go out here again. There's really nothing much, but that was originally a tomb, and for James O'Carroll of Drogheda, and that was the big door going into it, and his body is buried somewhere in there. So let's go into the monastery itself. Let's walk up onto the right hand side here on the way out, and let's start our investigation then. I just thought that was very, very unusual there for the to see all the bodies. So let's go in the monastery. Let's see what we can pick up in the monastery. Carling, if the kids at home are getting any way frustrated at all, get on to me straight away. Let's go up here first. Let's start up here. Let's turn around the camera here. So Caroline, is Caroline watching now? Caroline, are you watching now? Caroline, hello Carolina. Caroline, are you there? I have to keep in, hello Caroline, are you there? Yes, is everything okay at home with the kids? Are you happy out? Waiting for a response. If not, I'm just waiting for Caroline to come back to say she's all right. Hello Caroline, are you there? Yes, love you too. Right, so far, I'm only giving the guided tour. You all seen the skulls of the kids and everybody in the graves. That's absolutely amazing. For a paranormal investigator to find a place like this, absolutely spooktacular. So now, wait till you see this. We're in the monastery, and look how big that monastery is. Going right down the end, right huge. This was a huge, huge place in its time. Look at that. Look at the size of that place. So let's take you through the monastery now. And let's see what we can pick up in the monastery. Let's show you all the rising rain. Let's get out the spirit box. It is starting to spit down the rain a small bit. So let's take you through it. Let's see what we can pick up. Let's see what we can sense in it. But definitely the poor kids of Ireland to come into this monastery here. And the priests to forget about them and throw them into a tomb. And look, they die. So let's hope you all enjoy this investigation. I'm enjoying it so far. Let's hope the rain will stay away. So there's another tomb there. And when we start our spirit box sessions, please let us know where you want us to go. I'm going to go trying through it in lovely memory of Martina Feeney Lout, died 30th of April 1947. Brendan Grimes died the 7th of August 1959. His wife Mary Ann died 25th of January 1974. So, and there's loads of other little graves here. So let's bring you through bit by bit, see what we can pick up. And we look at the monastery bit by bit. And then I show you another wee old grave that I spotted up here. And then we'll take you through bit by bit. Caroline would love to be here. Trust me, Caroline. This is where Caroline, I think, should be feel more comfortable at this location. Definitely, we would definitely come back here the next fine evening we get, because I think Caroline would really, really enjoy it. Now, this looks like another tomb, a big tomb here, but I cannot see it. It's C-H-I-G-I-N. C-H-I-G-I-N. Something written like that on it. I can read it. And C-H-I-G-I-N, I think the name is written on that. So let's go through it bit by bit. Loads of hundreds of little old tombs. I say all the monks are buried here, be honest. Let's try and get it through as much as we can. And then what we'll do is then we'll try our spirit box session then. And then I'll have a chat to you and let me know where you want me to put the... Where do you want me to start? So there's so much we can look at here. There's so much stuff here to go through, so many different graves, hundreds of little different graves. I actually don't feel anything yet, don't feel threatened, don't feel anything like that. The tomb, Caroline says, yeah, we'll definitely be starting at the tomb. Someone's dragging me down to the very end down here, Richard Marion, who died the 17th of June 1893, age 53 years. Also her father, Nicholas Marion, who died the 26th of October 1854 and 56 years. And also his mother, Ellen Marion, who died the 22nd of November 1885, age 87 years. So that is that one there. We're going to bring it through bit by bit. And someone says there was a tomb, there's a grave here of a nun who served in World War I, and she was a nun. So Loch Carroll's buried here, Here we are, in the army. That probably isn't it. That'd probably her, isn't it? Kathleen Carroll. QM Army AUX Crops. Whatever that means. 19th of July 1918. Age 27 years of age. So that's probably her. So she served in the Queen's Mary. So you can see there, the Queen's Mary, the AAC. The letters are AAC Queen Mary, and the letters are 44412 workers. You can see it there, 44412 workers. Kathleen Carroll, QM Army AUX Corps, CORPS, 19th of July 1918, age 27 years of age. Her, that must be definitely her. So let's make our way out. So we found her tomb. So remember them names out when we're doing the spirit box session. You never know what the name of Jesus we're going to pick up to. But full of nettles, let me a pair of shorts on. So let's make our way through. Let's make our way out of here now. This is the monastery itself, and let's go and show you one or two more things. And then we're going to chat to you, and you're going to tell me exactly where you want me to start tonight. Carly says she wants to start on the tomb, and let's make our way out here. And you can see there's another tomb of another child's face there. You can see it there. And Reed says the tomb as well. So this is the tomb. I'm going to bypass the tomb for a minute because I'm going to have to make my way up. And the people brought down my stuff and the keys in the car. Just to make sure they're all there as well. They're probably gone home legging it to watch this live on YouTube. So if they are, thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. They didn't want to come on the television to give me any history or evidence, but they told me roughly some of the stories. And here's another headstone there. But the kids, it was enough for me once I heard the kids were brought into the monastery from the people, the old folks of Ireland. And see these big high gates here, I guarantee you one thing, there's how many tubes, three tombs here. Let's have a look. I guarantee you the Colemans are written here. Colemans, Thomas Coleman. I can see one name it. And these are the look at that. Let's open it up. Let's have a look. Let's get into there. Why were they so protected? John Coleman, Thomas Coleman. Three big names here. Another tomb here. Look at that. Why were they so protected and penrains and the poor old kids have nothing. So let's go through it. Another tomb here on the right hand side. You can see it all falling down. Guarantee you that's a monk. There. And there's another one here on the right hand side here, you can see it there. That's loads of other ground. As I'm walking through, paid by the church, you're probably 100% right. I'm walking through all these high grasses here and you can see loads of other tombs all forgotten about. I'd say most of them are probably kids. You can see, look, more of them all down here. Most of these are all kids' graves. And there's another big tomb here on the right. Look at all these little graves here, hidden here. These are all definitely all children's graves. Look at all these tombs here. All these tombs here. And the priests and the monks have massive big tombs over them. And they made sure they weren't forgotten about. Yeah, that's definitely in the monk. There's a few monks buried there. You can see it there yourself. And there's another one here, another big tomb here on the right hand side. Fair play to the people coming out cutting the grass, so, because people now, like me or anybody else coming here to visit this cemetery, they can come and experience and see what is forgotten about. Right, so let me grab what I need and let's start this investigation. Of the whole graveyard himself, of the whole monastery itself. You're all going to get an opportunity, Anne-Reese, Caroline, Gilligan, all of you are all going to get an opportunity, tell me where you go, but please do not forget about the house itself out in the field where the kids were buried and forgotten about. There's the car down there. So, let's get what we need. Let's go up here. Let's get what we need. So let's bring the bag down, let's bring the bag of tricks down, and let's turn around the camera. So there's 28 people running, watching. Right, so good evening. So our moderators, the 29 people are watching. Where do you want me to start my first spirit box session, and where do you want me to put the ramp pod? Let's get this up and running. Caroline says, hello. Hello, Caroline. So Caroline wants me to go to the tomb. Is that the one, the monastery? So we're going, they're saying the monastery, the tomb. Let's see, can we, so Caroline says the tomb. The tomb, by the tomb, right? Let's go by the tomb. We will do three or four different places, but we have to remember Caroline is at home. And once Caroline says she wants me at home, we have to go home. And we're and seeing the child. Okay, that's fine. Let's do that. Let's go downward and see the child. Oh, this is good. So far, so good. And saw a child. Let's go and see. Can we find this child? And I said there'd be loads of spirits of children here. I'm not one bit afraid anyway. We love the kids are all in our own house, all watching this live. So make sure you like and hit that like button. And always remember to say thanks underneath the comments, because all these. Yeah, it's coverage is alright, not too bad, not too bad. So, I'm outside here, the tomb. I should have brought the deck chair as well so I could sit down. So there's the tomb. I'm not going to put it on towards the tomb yet. He's freaking us all out. Not going to tell you yet. Me laughing now. So let's go. So what I'm going to do is, I'm letting you know what I'm going to do. So, going to put the ramp pod. We all know what the ramp pod is. I'm even going to take out the K2 meter. I have that as well. There is the ramp pod. Ramp pod is going on. Going to set the middle button. Now, Anne Reeds, you're watching. Anne is watching. Do you want me to put this at the door? Loads are. He will picking up on it. Do you want me to put this at the top of the tomb or right down where the bodies are? So let me. What the hell, Jesus. Right, so here we go. Do you want me to put it down there or do you want me to put it up on top of there? Bottom. Okay, just give me a second. Alright, just want to set the camera up first, okay? Make sure we have it all set up rightly. Make sure we're not going to miss anything. Do you want to make sure all the legs are completely straight? So make sure we get everything sorted. Just give me a second now, and I'm going to need to sort out and make sure I have it done right, so we don't miss out on anything. So there's the bottom of the tomb. You all agree? You're happy enough with that? Okay, so I'm going to put the ramp pod down there. Okay, just give me a second. Would you like to have a better look before, one more look at the bodies before we go into it? With the big light. I have the big light now. Hang on. Would you like to have a look at it? Yeah, hang on, we'll have a look. Before we start. Okay, because we have the big light here now. You might see the bodies better. There we go. You can try and get the, try and bring the Wi-Fi. We got everything up. Try and get the lights going up as well. Knock off the lights. They're starting to blind me. Just give me a second. Okay. Second out. Okay. I'm gonna try and get everything set up so you'll all have a good view of it as well, as same as me. So we're just going to try and get everything leveled up so you can see it. And we're going to put the ramp pod right down the very end as well. So, as you can see, the ramp pod is sitting at the door. I have one of the lights shining in towards it. Let's see if we get this grave up and active now. And let's hope that some spirit... Are you coping? How are you coping? So that Caroline is talking to Lorna there. So, let's go up and running. So, earphones on. So earphones on, guys. Let's try our first spirit box session here at this tomb, okay? Earphones on now, guys. Before we might do that... Let's get it up and running. Just gonna try and find the app now. So earphones in, let's do our first spirit box session at this tomb where you can see the bodies. And I will, if anybody requests to see the bones again and the heads and the skulls, just say it underneath the chat and talk to one of our moderators, our Caroline. And Caroline will pass the information on. And if I miss the chat, if you want to see the bones or the heads or the skulls, let us know and we'll show you again. Good evening, spirits of St. Mochta's Monastery. My name is Philip. I'm a paranormal investigator. I come with love, joy and respect of this beautiful, known as St. Mochta's Cemetery. If there's any spirits here, or spirits of wee children, monks or priests, can you come around me, please? My name is Philip. I am a paranormal investigator researching evidence in the afterlife. St. Mochta's Cemetery holds a big, massive history in relation to the Irish people in Ireland back in the years 500. This tomb, it's believed, I could see the skulls of many souls of many people. Two monks are believed to be buried in this with their arms cut off. I would say, roughly, I could see about 20 bodies in there. 20 skulls, 20 legs, 20 arms, you name it. Can you come forward and let me know that your presence is around me? It's believed that the Irish people back in the year 500 used to bring their kids and young children, young men and females to the monastery for the priests and the monks to help and feed their children and survive. But unfortunately, these kids that were under the care of the monks and the priests have died. And the priests and the monks have put them into tombs like what you see right now. And the remains are still lying to this very day in these tombs. Can any souls or any priests, monks or any children, please go down the steps, touch the red light. It will activate and turn green. And it would also let me know that your presence is around me. Try and communicate with the device I have in my hand and try and come forward and try and let me know your message of St. Mochta's Monastery. St. Patrick built another tomb to the right hand side of here where also children, women and kids have also died and the monks and the priests have also throwing the remains in these tombs. Is there any spirits here that wish to come forward and speak to me now? My name is Philip. Come forward, please.
Where?
My name is Philip. Can you touch the red light? Can you touch the red light? How many people are buried in here? My name is Philip. Be afraid of me. My name is Philip. Do not be afraid of me. Can you touch the
family?
Your family? Can you touch the red light?
Make it go green.
And make it go green? Can you touch the red light? Can you touch that red light, spirit, and make it go green? Is there any priest here?
No.
My name is Philip.
Okay.
Can you say my name, Philip? Can you say Philip? Is there spirits of children in this grave? Can you touch the red light again? Can you touch the red light again? What happened here in this monastery? What happened here in this monastery? Bad things. What happened to the children? What happened to the children in the monastery? My name is Philip. Can you say Philip? Can you touch that red light? You're baptized? Can you tell me what happened? What happened, you? Can you tell me what happened, you? Can you tell me what happened to this monastery? What happened to the children in this monastery? What happened to the monks who cut their hands off and thrown into this grave? Why did they cut their hands off? Why did they cut their hands off? Of the two monks? Why did they cut the hands off the monks? Why did they cut the hands off the monks? Were the thieves? Were the thieves? Children? What happened to the people that were thrown into this cellar here? Come on. Any children wish to come forward, please? My name is Philip. Come on. Come forward, please. St. Mocta's house. Can you say St. Mocta's? Can you say St. Mocta's? Can you say St. Mocta's? Come on. Can you say St. Mochta's?
What?
Don't be laughing at me.
There's an have to.
Don't be laughing at me. I take my job very seriously. I want to know what happened to the children in this graveyard. What happened to the children in this graveyard? 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 My name is Philip. What happened here in this graveyard? What happened here in this graveyard?
A dungeon.
The dungeon? Do you call it a dungeon? Can you touch that green light again? Right, guys, I have the Mel meter up on the right hand side. I'm also, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and put the Mel meter inside the grave. So just give me a second now. So this is the Mel meter. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and put this Mel meter inside the grave now. So what I want to do is I want to try and put my hand in the grave. I'll put this device inside it so you can reactivate the spirits inside this grave. One device, I have two devices in there now. I have one device sitting right inside the grave and the rampart is outside it. So the Mel meter is inside the tomb and the rampart is outside it. So we have two devices in there now. So let's see, can we get any of them knocking off? So I hope you can see that there. Two devices, the Mel meter is inside the tomb and the rampart is sitting outside the tomb. So let's hope we pick something up on that. Good evening, spirits. Can you come forward, please? Come forward, please.
I start.
My name is Philip.
Thank you.
What's your name? Is there a young spirit or a wee girl there? What's your name? Is there a wee girl there? A wee girl.
Actually,
what's your name? My name.
Yeah.
What's your name? My name is Philip. Harry, help me tonight. Can you? Can you ask the spirits of the wee children to come forward? My name is Philip. Spirits. Can you come forward, please? What happened, you? Okay, what's up? Is Michelle Philip? Philip and Howard, is Adam done? Care what though?
Hello?
Hello, yes? My name is Philip. What's yours? Are you happy? Are you happy here?
No, sorry.
Okay, what's up? Yes, my name is Philip.
Planes.
You have.
Is there anything? What happened? What happened to the spirits of the wee children here? So we're going to give it another ramble, okay? If you wish to see the bones of the people inside this grave, let me know. There's hundreds of bodies buried in here. If you wish to see them, I'll do one more spirit box session here, see what we pick up. If you wish to see the bones after, let me know. We're going to, and then we'll go over to the other tomb where the other bodies are. So let's refresh it. Then we'll talk to you, and if you wish to see them, we'll show you again, and then we'll move on to the next one, and then we'll walk around the whole place, and then we'll do the house. Okay, let's go.
Kehwatawak.
Is Mr. Philip? That's French. I'm waiting to come out.
We.
There's a French person here. Is there a wee spirit for a wee girl and a boy down there? Is the monk? What happened to the monks that are laid to rest in there, and their hands are cut off? What happened to them? Why were their hands cut off? Okay, so what I'm going to do is, we had a few minutes of that. So we're going to move the camera back to me for a second. Let's turn it around here to me. Let's turn it around all the way around here to me for a minute. And we're going to ask you yourselves the questions. So let's turn it around here. Let's get it up and running out. Just give me 2 seconds, guys. And we turn everything around, get everything up and running. I remember Caroline's at home with all the kids, and I want to try and cover as much as we can tonight. So let's turn around the camera. So what's your impression so far, everybody who's watching? There's 24 people watching. We're outside one of the tombs where there must be about 20, maybe 30 bodies in it. You can see the skulls are in there. Most of the skulls are all smashed, and there's legs and arms everywhere. There's hands, there's skulls everywhere in there. And you heard the story. And the story goes that there's two monks in here, and they're laid to rest in this tomb, and they have the big cross across them. I can't really see much of a cross, but I can see skulls and legs and heads everywhere. And the story goes that the people of Ireland brought their kids into this monastery for the priesthoods and the monks to look after the kids, and hoping that the priests and the monks would look after the kids. And when the parents came to the gates to get the kids, that the kids would walk out. But unfortunately, all the kids died, and they were thrown into little places like this one and the other one, and outside the little place outside. So, I can see a girl, says Gilligan Daniels. Elizabeth says it's a brilliant place, Philip, and scary. Birmingham Ghost Hunter said it's an amazing place. Caroline says don't forget a cup of tea. What I'm going to say to you guys is, what age did you get? What age did you get, Anne? I heard someone walk behind me. Definitely a brilliant place. So the 22 people are watching. Do you want me to do another spirit box session here? Do you want me to do a Paratex app here? Do you want me to show you the pictures, the live link of the bones and body here? Do you wish to do another spirit box session here? Do you want to do a Paratex app here? Or do you want me to go over here to the one on the right side and repeat what I've done here? So this is your life. What do you want me to do? Remember now, Caroline wants me to get home as soon as possible as well. So this is your chance now, guys. So what would you like me to do here? Birmingham Ghost says do a Paratex app here. I'm just waiting for you all to come in. Caroline's probably Paratex app, Suzanne. So is Caroline still there? Paratex app. So looks, they're looking like for a Paratex app. Do you wish to the Paratex app to be on me or down in the tomb? Please let me know while I get it set. Paratex app on me. Yes. So do you want the Paratex app? Do you want me to hold the phone like this, or do you want me to point it down onto the tomb? Let me know when I'm getting it all set up. Of course, Paratex, this will get interesting. Do you want the Paratex? No. Do you want the camera pointed to the tomb, or do you want it pointed to me? Let me know in chat. Let's do all this together. Little girl has had a bonnet on down by the tomb. So let's do it up down by the tomb. Let's make sure that is turning in. So let's turn it back to the tomb. Let's turn it back to the tomb. And we turn it back just in case any of them devices do set up. So it'd be actually amazing if any of them do rip off. The RAM pod is twiggling a small bit, but not as active as I wanted. The spirits probably don't even know what I'm doing. But eventually, after the second or third trip coming here, they will probably get used to who I am. So there it goes. Pointing it at the tomb. I'd probably try in a small bit more for you guys, so I'll probably do it like that so you can see a bit more, and I'll leave it there like that just in case you see it or any screenshots you want to do. I'll leave it at that. So here we go, Paratex in. Let's see what we pick up on the Paratex app, and then we move over to the next tomb on the right hand side, and then we do a quick walk around, and then we show you the other place. So if before we leave this one, though, we'll show you the bones inside. So let's do a Paratex app. So let's go. Good evening, spirits. My name is Philip from Paranormal Tech. Any spirits wish to come forward, please?
Paratech loaded. Started scanning.
Good evening,
spirits. Leader.
So the was leader. So the first thing got a leader. Spirits, I am in St. Moctis Monastery. It's believed that there's two monks buried in here with their arms cut off. Many hundreds and children have been buried here in this graveyard, unmarked by the monks and priests here of this St. Moctis Monastery. Is there any spirits of
out.
You out? Look at that, the word out. So the first word we got is out. Do you want out of this graveyard? Or do you want me out? If you want me out. My name is Philip. I'm a paranormal investigator researching in evidence in the afterlife of St. Moctis Monastery. It's believed that the priests and the monks here have taken in hundreds of children.
Out.
Culled. See the word culled. What happened to the two priests?
70.
Is there 70? Are you relating to the 70 people buried here in this tomb? Is there 70 kids in this tomb? What are you trying to tell me? What are you trying to tell me? Spirits of Saint...
Insects,
yes. Can you tell me what happened to you, spirits? Can you tell me what happened to you here in St. Moctis Cemetery? What did the priests and the monks do to the children here in this monastery?
Office.
Was there 70 children culled here? Was there 70 children culled here?
Device.
Is there any monks watching me right now? Any priests or monks watching me right now? If there's any wee children, or girls or boys, who are lost and forgotten about here, can you give me your name? My name is Philip.
Dread.
So the word dread, D-R-E-A-D, the word dread has come true. What do you dread? Spirits, what do you dread? Come on.
Vacation.
Vacation. You dread a vacation. Come on. Try and give me some real evidence of Saint Moctis. Who is Saint Moctis? Who is she? And why do you call her a saint? If she was a saint, I'm hell on earth. Of the monks and the priests of here of this monastery, they would not throw the kids into an old tomb like that.
Bliss.
And forgotten about. Bliss. Why were the children...
Quake.
Quake. So the word quake is coming in. Why were the children forgotten about here in this monastery? Why were the
children...
Limping. Are you limping? I'm not limping. I'd probably leg it if you give me some evidence. You got to do better than this, spirits.
Nine.
So we're going to let it run for another minute, guys, and see what we pick up. And then I'm going to show you another sight.
Vanish.
And the word vanish is coming through. Can you touch the red light and the green light? Any spirits, can you touch any of them lights that I have lit up on the tomb? They will light up like a Christmas tree and show me that your spirit is very active here. Can you touch them?
Trouble.
Trouble? I'm no trouble. I come with love and respect. I am a paranormal investigator researching in evidence in the afterlife.
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth. Hello, Elizabeth. I think I've seen Elizabeth's name here. Are you a spirit in here, Elizabeth? Who is Elizabeth? Who are
usual.
You? You're usually... Okay. Elizabeth...
Abyss.
Abyss. Elizabeth, what happened to the two monks? Why did they get their arms cut off? Come on.
Length.
Length. All right, spirits, this is your last chance. Come forward, please. Give me some evidence of the afterlife.
Hour.
Hour? Okay, I'm going to give you one more go, and then I'm going to show the folks the bodies inside the tomb before we...
Ease.
So the word ease and hour. So what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to move on to the next one. Before I do that, I want to take you down to the tomb and try and show you another one or two little clips off it as well. Just give me a second, guys, and I'll try and tighten everything up. Everything is getting loose on me. So let's turn around. Don't tell me what you got on this, but what have you picked up yet until before we start again. I'm just going to tighten everything up, make sure everything's plugged in and charging. Lights turn up, because I want to show you before we move on to the next one. So that is the tomb there. That is the tomb there. You can see it there. Let's move out of that a minute because it's all zoomed in. So that is the tomb there. You can see it there. That is one of the tombs. And there's loads... That spirit box is still going and says induce. I had that turned off. So I had that turned off. I don't know why I have it turned off. So Matty UK has joined us. Let's turn off that Paratex app a second, guys. Just give me a second.
Scanning stopped.
All right, so scanning stopped. Let's turn around this. So everybody who's joined, hello to Matt UK, hello to Elizabeth, there's Caroline Chess, hello to Caroline, there's Lauren in chat as well. So all our matters, there's 25 people watching us right now. And Matt UK, if you just joined us, we're in St. Moctus Monastery in County Loud. A massive history to this place. The story goes that in the famine years, back in the year 500, people from Ireland used to walk the children in here to the monastery for the priests and the monks here to take care and hopefully cure their kids of starvation and sickness. But unfortunately, they threw them into little cells like these and they were left to die. And when the parents came to the gates to the monastery looking for the kids and children, they were probably told by the monastery that their kids have passed on and died, and they put them into two tombs. One tomb is over here. That tomb over there was built by St. Patrick himself. And they put the kids of the children in there that were dying of foot and mouth disease or whatever, and they left the bodies in there, and that's where they died. And we're standing situated on another one here, and we're just going to show you as well. And we're just going to bring you to this one. We spent about an hour this one, so we're going to try and show you as much as we can. So this is one here. Some of our moderators have said they've seen a spirit of a wee child standing on top of this grave. And this is a graveyard to forgotten children, and there's a house outside it called St. Mochta's House, and the lady said there's hundreds of wee babies buried in that locality where people brought their sick children here when they were dying or passed away, and the monks and the priest buried them in unmarked graves outside this chapel. So we're going to try and show you the bodies in here, and then we'll move on to the next one. But I definitely think this is where the two monks were, because you see the sign there, it says RIP, and you can see the PHS written on the tomb. So let's try and get in here and let's try and show you the bodies, and we'll move on to a different location. So let's try and get it. Let's hope the coverage doesn't go on us. We'll try and get you as I know Matt is only after join us. You have to take my word, there's loads of bodies in here, guys. Loads of them. You can see some skulls there, look at that. Definitely loads of skulls in there, you can see them. We'll come back down the single, but I will get it, don't worry. Just bear with me. I'm going to try my damn to get it for you guys. Just give me a go in. I have to go in and out a few times for you to get the guys said. So let's try and bring it in. This place was a cardboard box. So let's try and see what someone said there, Elizabeth. This place was a cardboard box. Babies is a very, very haunted and very in motion, and they are trying this flying. I think we need a road trip to Ireland, Joanna. Oh my God, Elizabeth, awful years ago. I want to try and get you to show you these pictures of these. Let's try one more time. Let's get it back one more time. I know I can do this. Let's try it again. There's hundreds of bodies. You have to take my word, guys. Hundreds of bodies in there. Not just one, it's hundreds. Right, there's one there. I can see a skull. Oh, there's hundreds of bodies in there, guys. Absolutely hundreds of bodies in there. Poor souls. Look at that. There's loads of skulls there. There's not just one skull there, guys. There's hundreds of skulls in there. Absolutely hundreds of skulls. That's just me, guys, now. Just bear with me now a minute. I'm gonna have to knock off that ramp and try and get in here for you guys. Right, let's try and do it here. There you go. Now, can you there, guys? Let's see, can I keep that there so you can see it? There you go. No bones in the walls here. From Proven Demons, this is the real stuff here. I'm not taking the piss, or not taking the mickey. This is the real stuff here, guys. I'm not taking the piss at all. No bones in the walls here. This is the real McCoy. Look at that. Can you see that, guys? So let's move you back up here. I'm glad now I got it. So just give me a second now, guys. And the reason why they're left there, if you're watching the beginning, you would have got the information. So just give me a second. The reason why the bodies are still left there is because the people of Ireland back in the year 500 brought their kids and children into this locality for the priests and monks to cure them and feed them. And when they died, they threw them down there. Right. So let's move to a different spot now, and we'll just knock off the backlight. Give me a second, guys. sure the keys are there, is it? So to get out, and we just take it from that locality. So we're going to move on to a different spot now. Right, Caroline, if you're watching in chat, let me know, are you still okay? If you want to come home, I will come home straight away. If the kids are starting to be unfair to you, let me know and I'll come home straight away. I'll drop this live chat and I'll come home straight away. If you want me to come home, I will come home, because that's what we're here for. Before we do it. So let me know, Caroline, in chat, if you're still there, do you need me to come home? I will come home straight away. So just let me know, Caroline, or Anne-Reese, does Caroline need me? No, Caroline wouldn't be in the pub. That's why I phoned Caroline. I don't drink or anything like that. And Caroline is magic to me. No. We're outside the next tomb, and we're not going to start in any other part of the investigation until I get in contact with Caroline. Let's turn around the camera. So, before we move on to our second part of the next tomb that was built by St. Patrick, Caroline, is everything okay? Do you need me to come home? Because I will drop everything and come home straight away if you need me. So this live stream is all down to Caroline. If Caroline wants me to come home, I will come home. So let's all wait on Caroline. She's thinking. Bum, 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 bum. I can sit. So I'm going to wait here till I get a response from Caroline. Caroline, do you need me to come home now? And we'll come back and finish this off. Or do you want me to continue on to the second tomb? Oh, my fortune. Caroline, do you want me to continue on? Do you need me to carry on, Caroline? I can stay here all night until I get an answer. No. Caroline mustn't be watching. What do you think, Anne? Do we keep going? Do we keep going? She's drinking gin. No, Caroline wouldn't drink. So anyway, while Caroline's waiting, I will turn... is on her fourth gin. Caroline is drunk. Yes, continue, honey. Right, so Karen says continue. Right, so let's put on the next one here now. The tomb that we're underneath at the moment was built by St. Patrick himself. This monastery known as St. Moctus Cemetery, when the Irish people back in Sede walked their kids into this graveyard, and when they asked the monks, the priests, to take care of the kids, that they were starving with the hunger, and the monks and priests took their children in here. Now, Ireland hasn't got a great history of priests and monks and archbishops and so on, so on. So you could, even when the mammies and daddies brought their kids in through them gates over there, for the priests and the monks to take care of the children. And when their kids starvation or they died of sickness, the priest put them into tombs like this one and the other one you're only after seeing, and left them there to die. There's hundreds of bodies in these tombs, and they're still lying here today. So let's turn around the light and show you this other tomb. And we'll try and set up the rampart here as well. So we'll see, can we get it? Let's see, can we get it in here and this? So there is bodies in here too, guys. You're just gonna have to bear with it. There is bodies in here as well. So there's one or two big skulls here and one tombs as well. So I'm just going to see how will I be able to get in more for you to see it, if I can get it in more for you guys. Let's see, can I get this done better for you guys? Let's see, can we get the light in better? Let's see, can we get it in better? So you have to try and picture, there's, you can see to the left hand side, there's one or two skulls there, and over to the right hand side There is one or two. There is another body over there as well, and there's loads of different bodies and skulls. There is a big hole on the far side of it. I wonder, can we get to the far side? There shows another hole there. We might get the camera through that. I don't know if we can get into it or not, but let's show you that. We'll probably do that on the way out, but let's see, can we show you what's in here? If you can see, there's more bodies in there, guys. Loads of them. That side, and there's more over that side. So what we'll do is we'll do a small spirit box session here, and we'll do a small spirit box session here on this one, on St. Patrick's tomb, and then we'll walk around with the spirit box and see what we can pick up here, and we'll move on to the next one. So what we'll do is, that is what we'll do here. We'll walk here, just give me a second, and we'll do a box session. So we'll just turn that down there. And let's do a small spirit box session here on this one, outside St. Patrick's tomb. And the reason why they call it St. Patrick's tomb, because St. Patrick himself built this tomb here for the kids. So let's try and do it. We'll put on the spirit box session here. We'll let it run and we'll walk through it and see what we can pick up. Good evening, spirits. My name is Philip. St. Patrick built the tomb. What happened here in St. Mochrie? What happened? What happened here? What happened here? What happened here in St. Mochrie's cemetery? Monastery. What happened here? What happened here?
Nobody.
What happened here? What happened here in St. Mochrie's? Come on, what happened here?
From.
What happened here?
Filming.
Hear that? Filming. Let's walk through the monastery. What happened here? What happened here? What happened to the children here in St. Mochrie's Cemetery? Why were the priest's hands cut off? Why were the priest's hands cut off here? Can any spirits come forward in relation to St. Mochrie's Cemetery? My name is Philip. If you repeat my name, can you do it? Can you come forward, please? What happened here? What happened here? What happened here in this monastery? Come on. Can you try and use the equipment I have in my hand and try and communicate with me? What happened here in this monastery? How many kids and children are buried here? Can you repeat my name? Can you say Philip? Can you say Philip? Can you repeat my name and say Philip? Can you come forward, please?
From the left.
Can you come forward, please? Can you come forward, please? Queen Mary, Queen Mary, AAC, 444-12 Walkers, Kathleen Carroll. Queen Mary Army. AUX Crops.
It's just done.
19th of July, 1980. He died at the age of 27 years of age. Kathleen Carroll.
So.
Kathleen Carroll. Queen Mary. AAC. 44412 Worker. Kathleen Carroll. The Queen Mary Army, AUX, Crops, 19th of July, 1918, age 27. Kathleen Carroll, is your spirit here with me tonight? You worked for the Queen Mary Army, AUX, Crops, 19th of July, 1918, you died at the age of 27. 44412 Worker. AAC, Queen Mary.
Easy.
Kathleen, can you come forward and say Kathleen? What does the letters, the numbers 44412 workers mean?
Ours.
Singing.
Why am I?
Kathleen Carroll. 44412 Crops.
Actually,
was this your army number?
Yeah.
Are you here with me? Did you work in the army? Harry, can you help me find the children of this graveyard? Come forward, please. Thank you, Harry. Who's a wig? What's your name? Harry. Harry, bring the Harry, bring the kids forward, please. Harry, come forward, please. Harry. Can you get them to say Philip?
Seven.
Seven? Is this following me?
Seven.
Is there seven kids following me, Harry? Can you get them to come forward? Say their names. Tell them don't be afraid. I'm going to walk around Makta's house now. My name is Philip. Come forward.
Okay.
Harry, bring the children forward, please. Seven children, follow me, please. Come on.
Looking at
me. You're looking at me. Come on. Or am I looking at it? Where are you?
Yeah.
Come on. We're kind of
potentially.
Potentially. Come on. Can you do better than that? Monks. Where are the monks? Where are the priests? The cowards. Are the cowards? Where are these priests? Where are these priests and nuns? Oh, mommy. Did you hear that? Mommy. Who said mommy? A girl said. A girl said, mommy. Are you looking for your mommy?
So.
Are you looking for your mommy? You look, can you come forward, wee one? Wee girl? Where's your name? What's your name, wee one? Come, don't be afraid. My name is Philip. Come on. Do you want to follow me? Are you looking for your mommy? Did your mommy leave you here for the priests and monks to make you better?
Because.
Come on. Harry, help me. Get them to say Philip.
Come on, we're going to go out to the church now. St. Mark's Church. Let's see, can we get St. Mark's come through? St. Mark's, come forward. Howard. Don't be a coward, come out. Don't be a coward, come out. Are you saying you're here? Where are you? Where are you? Come on. Where are you? Come on. Where are these monks and priests?
To me.
Where are you? Where are these monks? Where are these monks and priests? Where are you hiding? Where are you hiding? So we're gonna lock this gate here, guys, and we'll go over to the house. Just give me a second out. Just gonna lock these gates here, and we're gonna show you the house before we one more tour thing to do. So that's the gate locked. I'm just gonna leave the bag on one side of me here a minute, and we'll try and show you that. We'll walk around this side here. So we're just going to turn around the camera here a second. And there's so much to probably to investigate here. There's so much stuff to do. So just going to turn this around, tighten this up a small bit. Let's turn on the light. Turn on the light. And we'll turn it down a small bit. Turn it down. There we go. And we'll turn around the light. Right, we just turn around. Every time I want to turn around the camera, I won't turn around. Turn around, you devil, you turn around. There we go. We'll turn around. Are we? Yes, so we're turning around. They are the gates of St. Mochta's Church, or monastery as known as. And this is where the people of Ireland, back in the famine days, walked their kids to these gates here and greeted by the priests and the monks. Where the kids were dying with starvation and hunger, and maybe dying from other diseases. The priests offered and took them into the monastery, and hundreds of kids have walked into these gates. Probably wasn't these gates, probably other gates back in the time, but hundreds of kids have walked through these gates and never came out. And many hundreds of mammies and daddies have came to these gates looking for the kids to come back probably, and never walked out, where the monks and the priests put them into tombs. You can see them. There's hundreds of skulls and legs and arms and everything in there. Unbelievable. So let's show you St. Mochta's house. We'll turn around the camera now as well, and we'll probably be in the big yellow torch with it as well, and we'll leave everything else behind us because we won't get too much today, because that's not fair in Caroline. We're actually an hour and 50 minutes into this. Let's go to St. Mochta's house now, and we'll show you St. Mochta's house. And St. was built back in the year 500, where St. Mochta's, this is where the Saint St. Mochta's lived in it. And the story goes, a nice old lady there, she was in there cleaning the cemetery, and she says that many of women of Ireland, when their children did die, they asked the priests to bury the kids in the monastery. And the priests buried them out here in this land out here, and in unmarked graves. And it's believed that people says that there's a possibility there could be hundreds, and possibly thousands of babies, of young women who brought their kids here to be buried here in the monastery. And the priests and the St. Mochta's, St. Patrick's time, and they're saying that there's hundreds of bodies built here in this property around St. Mochta's house. And it says that to this day the people in Ireland will never know how many kids are buried here in this ground here where we're walking. Heading towards St. Mochta's little chapel. This is where St. Mochta's, to believe herself, lived in her own little chapel away from the monastery. So that was the monastery there on the right-hand side. And St. Mochta's herself lived in this little chapel outside the monastery. And it believed to be a little one bedroom up on top and a little church down the bottom. And the OPW have it locked up. And you know yourself with the ute. If they got in it, they'll destroy it. And it's to believe it's believed that chapel was built in one night for her to live in. And it's believed that there's hundreds of babies buried here in the ground. So as I'm walking, we're going to do a spirit box session and see do we pick up any spirits of any children around here. And then we walk around the chapel before we finish up, and we will definitely return here. So let's, we'll not ignore chat. Karen's there, our moderator's there. So let's do a spirit box session here. Let's get it up. Let's see what we pick up. Is there any spirits of wee children here, out here in this lawn, out here in this, out here, please?
I'm coming.
You're coming, thank you. St. Mochta's house.
Halloween.
A lot of people.
Is there a lot of people buried? Is there a lot of people buried here? St. Mochta's house. How many children are buried here in unmarked graves? Can I ask who's coming? Who's coming? How many children are buried here? How many children are buried here? How many children are buried here? Is St. Mochta's spirit here? Who? Who lived in this house? Who lived in this house? St. Mochta's. St. Mochta's house. Come forward, please. According to the legend, this church was built in a night to give shelter for the founder of St. Mochta's, who died in 1534, to present the church as probably built in the 12th century. Come on. Come on, spirits. Come forward, please. St. Mochta's. Who is St. Mochta's? Can you tell me? Who's St. Mochta's? Come on. Who's St. Mochta's? 1606 LCC. Come on.
Philip,
yes. My name is Philip. Who's speaking, Philip? Who's speaking, Philip?
Some of the ghosts.
Some of the ghosts? Wow, that's good. Some of the ghosts. Cool. So who's some of the ghosts? We call them spirits. Why do you call them ghosts? We call them spirits. We call them spirits. Why do you call them ghosts? Where we call them spirits.
See?
Well, come on. Why do you call them ghosts? 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 Why do you call them ghosts?
What?
St. Mochta's house. Why do you call them ghosts? Why do you call them ghosts? Why do you call them ghosts? Come on. St. Mochta's. Who is St. Mochta's? Come on. Tell me. Who is St. Mochta's? Come on. Who is St. Mochta's? And turn the light back on to me. So, did you hear that? My name came true. Philip came true. And I asked who said Philip. And the response I got was ghost. So I asked, this is St. Mochta's house. It's all locked up. We can't get into it. PW have it locked in. It's a small little chapel. St. Mochta's used to say our prayers in it, and there's a little one-bedroom house, little
one little bedroom apartment, with, as we call it today, in here. So this is where St. Mochta's herself would have stayed, saying her prayers, and she had one little bedroom apartment, and she slept away from the monastery itself, away from the monks and priests. I heard a past, and I heard Philip, I heard my name coming through, and I asked who said Philip, and the words we got, some of the ghosts, and that is the response I got. So we're just going to walk around here, let's refresh the spirit box session, and let's walk around the monastery for the last time before we say goodbye. So let's turn it around again, and we'll walk around and refresh the spirit box session. So we hope you're joining. We're nearly coming to the, we'll probably another couple of minutes, because it's not fair in Caroline. So let's refresh it. I'm enjoying it. Any spirits wish to come forward, please? My name is Philip.
Go to.
Where do I need to go to? Where do I need to go to?
Aubrey.
What happened here? Why did they call it St. Mochta's Monastery?
Yes.
Why did they call it St. Mochta's Cemetery? Mom, how many kids and children are forgotten here in this monastery? My name is Philip. Please do not be afraid of me. I come with love, joy and respect to the spirits of St. Mochta's Cemetery. If there's any spirits here in the cemetery that wish to speak to Philip, come forward now for the last time tonight. I'm going to walk around the outside of the cemetery and head back to the car. It's believed that there's hundreds of babies buried outside this cemetery, outside the monastery and St. Mochta's house. Come on. Try and use the device I have in my hand, and try and communicate with me, please. Come on. Harry, help the children come forward, please. Do you need help? Do you need help? Let's walk around the outside of the cemetery. Any monks here? Can you say the word monk? Can you say the word priest? Can you come forward, please? Come on. Yes, come on. I'm walking around where there's supposed to be hundreds of kids buried. Come on. Come forward, please. Don't be frightened. Don't be frightened. What's happening here? Come on, spirits. What happened here in this month? You hated life?
Two.
What happened here in this monastery? Come on. What happened here in this monastery? You can't answer that. Are you better? I command you to come forward, please. Come on. Has any priests any confessions to come forward? Have you any sins that you wish to bring forward? Is there any children in the spirit world wish to come forward and tell me what happened to you? My name is Philip. I'm a paranormal investigator. Questioning evidence in the afterlife. Do you need help? Do you need help to cross over? Say the word help. Come on, spirits. Do you need help? Do you need help? I'm going to go and chat to you now before we leave. Come on. Come forward, please. So she's going to make her way up here, and we're going to make our way back up here to the monastery. Yeah.
I'm only after them with houses.
Feels like.
Right, so we're outside the manor street. I'm going to have to rip my trousers. So, did I rip them bad? I did. Right, so let's turn this around. And we'll turn the camera around here to you guys. Let's try and turn. Did you get caught, Philip? I did get caught. I ripped my trousers. I did. I got caught and I ripped my trousers, so I did. So let's turn off the spirit box session. Let's turn off the spirit box session. So there's 21 people watching me. Live After Life TV is just after joining us. Samantha, did you get an opportunity to see the bodies in the tomb? What the hell was that? So I hope you enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. A great, great place. Definitely very, very unusual. So just before we finish up, I'd like to hello Paul Fitzmaurice, hello Sander from Paranormal Investigator, hello to everybody who's watching us. We're 2 hours in it, so that is an amazing place. So if you don't know where I am in St. Mochta's Monastery in County Louth. You've seen the bodies in the tomb. There's two tombs in it. Life After Life TV, she's a paranormal investigator as well in Ireland. I am in County Louth and Samantha is in up in Belfast, not Belfast, up towards Donegal. Yes, it was very cool, Phil. So Matt TUK is there. So I really, really enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed it. Brilliant place. Need to go back. Definitely need to go back here and start doing EVPs. I like to do and start doing EVPs. And I'm a big man of the EVPs. I like to ramble around with the Spirit Box session and do Paratech Zap. But that gate's behind me is a very, very no, Philip. I missed most of it. I will have to. You definitely, Samantha, you need to go back. This is a monastery known as St. Mochta's Monastery. The little house that I'm going to, that we're St. Mochta's herself staying in, and she had a little chapel and a one bedroom, a little house up above. These are the gates of the monastery itself. Back in the year 500, the people of Ireland, back in the famine years, way, way, way before that, used to bring their kids in here where there were starvation, where they were starved with the hunger, where they had diseases, and where they were very, very, very sick. And they asked the priests and the monks to take care of the children, and you seen the two cells where all the bodies were just thrown. There's hundreds of bodies there. There's hundreds of them. Absolutely hundreds of them. And when I came here this evening, the people of the town of Louth, known as Louth Village, were in cutting the grass. And one of the ladies in person, she said to me, she says that they found a tomb, which is the one you seen. And when they discovered the tomb and they went in, there were two monks inside the tomb. Straight, she said the skulls were face up towards the ceiling and they were lied, and she says you could see the symbol of the cross beside them. That's how they were indicated that they know they were monks. But she says these priests are monks. She would definitely say monks. She says their arms were cut off from their elbows, and the two priests were in there, their two arms were, both of the two priests' arms were cut off. And I'm not sure what she said about the legs. I forget what she said about the legs, but she says they were done as well. And I just thought it was very, very unusual. When myself and Carney did come here today and we seen all the bodies, and I sent the photographs to Anne Reed's, ma'am, and Carpy Chris, and Anne Gilligan, and Anne Reed's wanted me to ring the guards, so did Carney. And when I found out that's why where all the bodies were thrown, because that's where the monks threw them. So I want to finish it off with one round of a spirit box session just outside the gates. And then we'll do our goodbye song and then we'll finish up. But it's definitely a place we have to come back to. So, I feel choked up. I am due to go back to Turmerfeckin Castle very, very soon. But this place, I could not pass it out tonight. We'll just do one spirit box session and we'll finish it up then. See, can we pick up any spirits outside the gates of the monastery? And Jane Live generally said, thank you, Philip and Caroline, for letting Philip to go out and do an investigation. Yeah, Caroline's the boss. Always remember, the women are always the bosses. Right, Matt? So let's do one more spirit box session. Spirits off the graveyard of St. Mochta's Monastery. Is there any spirits with me now? Any spirits? Any spirits with me now?
heard your... He's got a...
How many people...
Yeah, that was...
Result.
Can you tell me what happened here? What happened here in this monastery? What happened here in this monastery? My name is Philip. Harry, can you get any of the kids to come forward before I go? Harry, come out, please. Harry, can you bring any, can you bring some of the kids forward, please? Harry, can you bring any... Harry, bring one of the kids forward. Come on, Harry. Do your best for me, please. Try and bring some of the kids forward, please. Come on. Come on, Harry. Do this for me for once. My name... Now, can you bring any of the kids... St. Marcus, priests... Come on, can you do your best for me?
I could.
Can you? My name is Philip.
Like what is?
Come on. My name is Philip. Come on. I'm standing outside the gates of the monastery. I'm just about to go home. Is there any spirits wish to come forward for the last time and speak to me before I go home?
Enjoy.
I do enjoy. Any spirits wish to come forward and pass a message to me before I go?
Yeah.
My name is Philip. Come on.
Hello.
Any monks in here that wish to come and say sorry to the people of Ireland? You come forward, please. Right, guys. I'm going to finish it up now, and I really do hope you enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. I always do enjoy coming out and doing it. We spent about 2 hours in it, so I do need to go home to Caroline now because it's not fair on her. It's up to Caroline where we're going to next. I think Caroline is going to come back here, to be honest, because if the weather's fine, you may have the weather in England, you may have the fantastic weather in England, but we in Ireland had 28 degrees today, but the weather was 28 degrees, but it was cloudy with no sun. But it's still warm, and myself and Caroline will probably do one more live. Probably next Tuesday night. We'll probably go to Turmifecan Castle if it's raining. But it's fine. I want to come back here for some reason. I just think that this place looks good, and I think that is it is quite an amazing place. I do like it. So it's before we finish, it's goodbye for me. It's goodbye from Caroline, and you will see us.
Need a little help.
You will see us live next Tuesday night, or we may even might be here.
It's all fixed there now.
So we hope you enjoyed it. So here we go. We hope you enjoyed.
The sun is clock is moving slow, so am I. Passes like molasses in winter time, but it's July, getting paid by the hour, the older by the minute. My boss just pushed me over the limit. I'd like to call me something, I think I'll just call it a day and pour me something tall and strong. Make it a hurricane before I go and say it's all. It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Miss Carmine out.
This lunch break is gonna Jamaican vacation's gonna start right here. If the phone's ringing, tell him I just sailed away. And pour me something tall and strong, make me a hurricane before I go and say it's only half past 12.
Guys, it's goodbye from me, it's goodbye from Caroline. We will be live next Tuesday night, hopefully, and we don't know where we're going to be. I would love the weather in Ireland were to stay fine to do a return back to this live, back into the cemetery. I loved it, we hope you loved it, Caroline loved it. So many paranormal investigations going. Please like and share, spread the word, and we'll see you soon on our next one. It's goodbye from me, it's goodbye from Caroline, it's goodbye from everybody who's watching. Appreciate it, thank you for joining us, and we'll see you on our next one. Goodbye for now. Slán agus beadad. Bye.